Anywhere from up here. Is she okay?
All right. Hi, everyone. I am Dominic Bednar, and today I will be sharing about my work title on my proposed project for my time here in Chile, modeling spatial disparities of residential energy efficiency and poverty and firewood use. So, energy poverty or pobreza energética is a issue that afflicts millions across the world. Folks often forgo food and medicine to pay their energy bills, sometimes experience utility shutoff, often unable to regulate comfortable temperatures in their homes, or have broken heating and cooling equipment. And so this has obviously pushed millions of people across the globe to just like organize for energy rights. See some of these folks here said mothers don't use their children for heat. We demand non-polluting energy and technology so our planet survives. And so really speaking to the centrality of energy and why it's so important for us all to have it. Some of my work has defined energy poverty, especially in the U.S., where we define it as a state where households are challenged by everyday situations and meeting basic energy needs because of this assemblage of socioeconomic, technical, and environmental political factors. Here in Chile, working with some folks, we kind of take a similar approach, but looking at, again, this core issue of having access to energy, is it adequate, reliable, they're trying to get to like the quality of the energy that they have, but also understanding like what are the spatial and distributive understandings of the energy. And so as kind of like an overview, the work that I've done before really, again, takes this like multi-dimensional approach to understand energy from this technical lens, understanding these like dwelling characteristics, the socioeconomic dimension. So normally if you have more people in your house, you're consuming a bit more energy. Does the head of household matter? Their race, ethnicity, gender. And then finally, environmental policy dimensions. And so where you're located matters. So consuming energy here is obviously starkly different than in Detroit, Michigan, where I spent a lot of time. But also like where you're at normally has an influence on the policies that are available insofar as energy assistance. And so taking all three of these dimensions together, it really helps us understand what are people's likelihood, or really helps speak to this vulnerability aspect of people's likelihood to experience energy poverty, and how can we think about that within this framework of risk assessment, and how those particular risks threaten or harm people's most treasured assets, their health, well-being, and yeah, so this again is energy vulnerability, which I just spoke about. Here in Chile, folks struggle with high energy prices. It has the highest per capita wood fuel consumption in the world, and energy consumption, particularly in the southern region, contributes to 80% of particulate matter pollution, which is really important, especially in the southern regions. And so I'm interested in understanding those particular effects, and again, like how communities understand and need and use energy differently. And these are all obviously aligned with the UN's Sustainable Development Goals, and goal number 7 is to ensure access to affordable, reliable, sustainable, and modern energy for all. What's interesting is that some of my work kind of like contrasts, at least like at a national level, how do we recognize and respond to energy poverty? And in the US, we don't particularly have a like formal recognition of energy poverty as a distinct problem, but we do have solutions, and so I call those solutions like this like pseudo-recognition. But contrasting the work in the U.S. to here in Chile, there's like this formal national goal. So in 2035, at least 100% of the homes, vulnerable families, having access to energy, and by 2050, having universal access. Makes Chile unique is that it has these diverse climate regions. And so, again, thinking about what does energy use look like across all of these energy regions, or all these climate regions, rather. And so, my questions, or my objectives are, one, to analyze how Chile's unique climate zones and socio-spatial patterns or elements shape energy poverty, and two, to propose policy guidelines for targeting and reducing energy poverty. And so my study region is, one, I guess like looking at the various climate zones, but to understand, I guess, like at a more local level, what communities' needs and interests are, Comuna Branca. And so I chose this work because my collaborators have ongoing projects in this region, and so being able to tap on where they already have some semi-structured interviews is beneficial. This is some of the previous work that my collaborators have done, looking at, again, like how is energy spatially distributed across the city of Santiago. And so I plan to kind of use like some similar skills that I've also done. This is a map here of Detroit, Michigan, or Wayne County. Detroit is kind of like this smaller boundary. Here you can see like heating energy consumption and energy inefficiency. And then this next one kind of really highlights the age of the housing stock and also incomes or energy burden, where energy burden is traditionally defined as the percent that a household is spending on their energy bill. The energy burden is an expenditure of people's household income as a percentage that they spend annually. And so really working to fill this gap that current policy frameworks and measures don't fully capture these geographical underpinnings of energy efficiency, affordability, and firewood use. And so the research questions that really drive this work are, one, how does energy efficiency, burden, and firewood consumption vary spatially across the Chilean climate zones and within Santiago? And then two, how are household energy needs defined by residents in Dominic Bednar, and what factors describe adequate household energy needs? And so this is kind of a mixed method study. So again, quantitatively using these spatial regression and GIS tools to again help better understand these spatial distributions of energy efficiency, but also some qualitative surveys and some structural interviews. Here are some existing data, some secondary data sources from Chile at national scale, and so I'm looking to explore some of these data sets to again see what we can find, what we can map, and what's really important. Here's a shout out to my collaborators, folks at PUC, Pontificia Universidad Católica de Chile, the Barred PE, which is the Energy Poverty Network here. And that is it.
Well, yeah, any questions, guys?
I have a question.
Sure.